Okay, so before I start with the second part of the video, you know, the Sunday section, just wanted to tell you guys that I actually had filmed the first and second part together in one go, but I lost all my footage from, you know, everything that I talked about Sunday. So now I'm here again in a different part of the apartment, filming this once again. So yeah, just in case you guys were like, whoa, you changed place. Yeah, basically I lost all my footage. But yeah, gotta do what you gotta do. Okay, so continuing on with, you know, everything that happened that weekend. Sunday I got up early, like at 9, 10, early-ish. And so yeah, I was just getting ready, eating breakfast, and I sat down to check social media, like I always do in the mornings. And then I see this message, but I don't know if it happens to you guys, but sometimes I get messages on Messenger, but it doesn't say from who it's from. It says messenger sent a message or message sent by messenger. And I'm like, what, who? So yeah, that happened to me. So I was like, okay, so probably it is that I'm on my other Facebook, and probably somebody sent something to my blog's Facebook. So yeah, I just changed, I switched accounts, and then I see this message from K-pop stars, and I was like, what happened? Did I do something wrong? Did I forget to like do something for the giveaway or something like that? So yeah, then I opened the message and they were like, congratulations, you are the winner of the ticket. And I was like, what? Why? What do you mean? What? I was like, huh? So yeah, I freaked out. I was like, no way. So yeah, I ended up being one of the winners. They were giving away actually two tickets to see Idol's performance at Le Poison Rouge. I won the giveaway. Unfortunately, my friend wasn't able to go because since it was last minute, she wasn't able to take off from work. So yeah, I went there by myself. And yeah, I was just super excited. I was like, because I wasn't going to be able to go. So I was really excited to be able to go, you know, see them perform live. And also, you know, just to check out the environment, because I've never been to the type of, you know, this type of event, which is like, you know, people. I thought it would be like a club or something. It's like, it had like that environment. I don't know if it's a club or it's like a lounge or something like that, but it had that type of environment, and I've never been to a K-pop event, you know, with that type of arrangement or type of environment. Like how many times am I going to say environment? So yeah, I've never gone to an event like that. Okay, so yeah, I was just really excited that I was going to be able to see, you know, Idol perform live and also have, you know, a new experience. So yeah, I just did everything that I had to do that, you know, Sunday. And then like around 5-ish, 5:30, somewhere around that time, I got on the train and went to 14th Street, to Union Square, because I decided that, you know, maybe I should print the ticket, because I had asked K-pop stars if, you know, if it was okay to just show the email, or, you know, did I have to print it? And they said, you know, just in case, just print it, you know, just in case anything happens with the email and whatnot. So I was like, okay, sure, whatever. So I got, the train was a bit late, but yeah, I got there like 15 to 6, and then I got to Staples. I got to Staples, and they had like 3 machines, something like that. 2 of them were not working. So yeah, I had to wait like, oh God. I had to wait like 15 minutes to be able to print out my ticket. And so yeah, after that, I just walked to the venue. The venue was like less than, I think the venue was like 15 minutes away walking. So yeah, I just walked all the way over there and found the place. It was super easy to find on Google Maps. So yeah, I went in, I showed them my ticket so they could scan it. They gave me a wristband and then like a mark or something on the wristband. And then, so yeah, I went in and everything was really dark and everything was really dark. Could hardly see people. And, you know, they were playing music, really, you know, and they were playing, like, what was it that they were playing when I came in? It was probably maybe, like, something like BTS or, no, not BTS, because there was nobody on the dance floor. I don't know. I don't remember what they were playing. But, yeah, everybody was just hanging around. There was a couple of people next to the stage, a couple of people next to the bar, a couple of people, you know, more back. So, yeah, I just went in and I met up with one of the girls that I met during Echo's get-together back in July. And I talked to her a bit and, yeah, I just, you know, just stood there and we talked a bit. And also, you know, they started to put a lot of K-pop songs and people, like, started to get excited and more comfortable with the place. And, you know, just little circle of friends dancing started to be formed. And I just, you know, found my little space in it, and yeah, I had fun. Everybody was like, you know, even if people didn't know the choreography, they were just, you know, dancing however they could, and you know, they would make circles, and then people would just go to the middle and either do the choreography or just improvise or whatnot. Yeah, it was really fun. You know, just being immersed in that environment. Everybody was super chill. Everybody just having fun. It was, I don't know, around like 7 or 8, more or less, people just started, and it was, I know it had to be because of a BTS song. I don't remember which BTS song, but I remember they played BTS, and then all of a sudden, like, a big circle started forming, and people would just, you know, started to dance to the choreography and whatnot. Then Card came out, and then people went to the middle, and Hyuna, and then Twice and things like that. So yeah, after a while, like, a big circle was formed and people would just form, you know, get in the middle and dance to choreography. There were some people who were actually like doing freestyle and what is that, b-boying, things like that. So yeah, it was just really cool. Yes, everybody was just having a nice time, you know, in the circle. I unfortunately can't dance. I mean, when it comes to like choreographed dance, I'm not really good at that. So yeah, I was just standing there looking at people dancing, which I don't know if that's weird or not. I mean, I don't feel like it's weird because I really love watching people dance and sing, and, you know, watching people be awesome at their craft. So yeah, I was just in the middle, not in the middle, I was just in the circle, just looking at people doing the choreography and whatnot. I tried to take videos, but the videos just came out really either blurry or in the dark, because this is one of the things that annoyed me. There wasn't a lot of light towards, you know, the dance floor. So a lot of people, like when we formed that big circle, a lot of people would just turn on the flashlight from their phones. You know, so people could be able to see each other, you know, better. And then if people were like taking pictures or video, you know, they could be seen in the video. So yeah, that was just one thing that annoyed me. Like, I was trying to take videos because there was a lot of people that night that were really talented, really knew like the dance of, you know, almost all the songs that came out. And yeah, it was just really cool. And I wanted to take, you know, videos and pictures just to post them on social media. Yeah, it was a bit difficult because everything was just so dark and the lights would just come and go and come and go, and I was like, oh, please put a spotlight here so people could dance and I could take a picture or video. But yeah, it was super fun. That's one thing that I really loved. The DJ, I don't know his name, but he did an awesome job with the selection of music, of K-pop songs, because there were so many songs from so many different artists. Like, for example, we had, and I put a list on my Twitter. It was obviously BTS, Twice, we had CLC, there was 17, Big Bang, which, thank you for putting Big Bang. We had Highlight, we had, I said Twice already, Hyuna, Pentagon, Block B as well, which really surprised me. Yeah, there was a lot of artists, and I was just really happy, like, you know, because it was just a continued how you say, a continued stream of different types of artists that he was giving. Like, it wasn't like he put like five songs of BTS one after another and then everything else. No, it was like BTS and 17 and then Pentagon and then a girl group and then something else and then something else, something else. And it was really, really fun. I was like, wow, okay, this DJ is doing an awesome job. And they were really good songs, songs that, you know, people could dance to and feel good to and, you know, just have a good time. So a DJ did an awesome job. I was really impressed. I was like, yes, thank you. Because honestly, I've gone to other events where one of the things that they have to work on is basically their playlist. It's like a lot of BTS, a lot of Blackpink, somewhat EXO, and then a couple of other artists here and there. It's like, you know, you have to diversify your playlist. And I love that he chose, obviously he chose BTS, Blackpink, but also, you know, they had other artists. And it was really awesome. You know, had a little bit of the old school artists and a little bit of the new school artists. So yeah, it was just super awesome. I really loved all the songs, the playlist that was chosen. It was really awesome. And he also played a couple of other songs that were in English. I know the Kiki song came out and I was like, okay. And everybody was like, oh, wait a minute. So yeah, that was cool. But yeah, it was a really good selection, and I just had a lot of fun just, you know, interacting with a couple of people, you know, watching everybody dance and whatnot. So yeah, so like around, I don't remember the time, but I know around 8 or 9, around that time frame, we had a couple of performers come out before, you know, Ted Park and Idol. And so the first performer, her name was J.U., if I'm not mistaken. I'm going to be putting her name obviously here on screen. She actually sang a cover of Beyonce's song titled Listen. The vibe, singing along and whatnot, and it was really, really nice to listen, you know, to her sing, and it was just really nice. It was really awesome. And then after that, we had a dance team. If I'm not mistaken, they're called I Love Dance. And there were two teams, two sets of groups. The first one were a dance cover for Blackpink. Oh, Recent comeback single, and yeah, they were really cool. I really loved like their vibe and stage presence, and also, you know, the outfits they had, and it was just really awesome. They were really good. They knew the choreography, and I love that they put their little they put their attitude, like a different vibe into it, in the sense that you know, each girl had her own style and you could like distinguish them. So yeah, it was not only the cover, but you could see they were putting a little bit of themselves in the cover. So yeah, they did awesome. And then after that, they did NCT's Boss, if I'm not mistaken, the song is called. I think it's them, but yeah, they obviously knew what they were doing. Like, these were professionals, and yeah, they were awesome. That cover was really cool. NCT is getting a lot of attention, and that song in particular has like an awesome vibe to it, awesome choreography, and they were really awesome. So yeah, after that there was like another break that we had. I don't remember if it was then that the organizer, I think one of the organizers, he was telling us that Idol was on their way. They were coming like from New Jersey. They would be here like a little bit late. So yeah, he was telling us to like sit tight and have fun and, you know, to spread out, you know, everybody to have fun. And they'll let us know when the girls, you know, have arrived and whatnot. So I was like, okay, cool. So yeah, everybody just went back to the circle. Everybody just started dancing and socializing. I decided to stay more towards the stage because, you know, I'm super short. 5'1", super short. So yeah, when everybody scattered, I just went a little bit closer to the stage just to, you know, have a better view. And then during, you know, my, during, obviously we have the stage and then the audience and then a couple of others were just in a circle dancing. And while we were, you know, while we were waiting for the girls to come, I was able to interact with a couple of K-poppers there, and they were so nice, so friendly. You know, every time a song would come up and they wouldn't know, I would be like, hey, is this artist, this song? And they'd be like, oh, okay, I didn't know. This is cool. This sounds cool. So yeah, we talked a little bit while waiting for the girls. I found out that, you know, they had recently started listening to K-pop. I know one of them told me she started in 2015 and whatnot. So yeah, because I told them, because they were like, oh, you know a lot of songs. And then one of the girls asked me, so which is your ultimate group and things like that. And I was like, no, I don't have an ultimate group or ultimate bias or nothing like that. I've been, you know, listening to K-pop since 2009. There's a lot of groups that I love, a lot of people that I listen to and support. So yeah, there's like a lot. And she was like, oh, okay, I get it. But of course, I talked to her. Obviously, I told her that, you know, I love Tombang Chinky, 21, Big Bang, JYJ, SHINee. But also, I listen to, you know, newer groups like, you know, Monsta X and Day 6, and also recently Pentagon, who, thanks to SHINee, I have fallen, you know, down the rabbit hole, as they say. I'm getting to know them, getting to know the members, their discography and whatnot. So yeah, like recently Pentagon, I've been getting into them. So she was like, oh, that's cool. So yeah, it was really nice, you know, to have somebody to interact with and talk to, you know, while we waited for the girls. And you know, the only thing I had to do was like turn around, because when I turn around, I could just see everybody dancing, turn back around, and I had the stage. So yeah, I was pretty in a pretty good spot. And yeah, it was really nice having, you know, someone to talk to. And it's so weird, but I'm so grateful for the weirdness. But you know, all since last year, I've been going to like K-pop events by myself, and I've always had like this weird thing that I've, you know, always found a friendly person to talk to, a friendly K-pop fan to talk to. And it was nice that in this, you know, this occasion, I also had you know, friendly encounters with other K-pop fans. And yeah, it was super nice. So yeah, around I think around like 9:40 to 10, around 9:40, yeah, like around 9:40 to 10, around that time frame, they started the show finally. You know, I was just relieved because my feet were hurting. I got there like at 6:30, and then since 6:30 on, I was literally on my feet. So I was my feet were hurting, but I was super excited that finally everything was gonna start. So yeah, the first performer was Ted Park. He's a rap artist. He signed with Jay Park's global label. I don't know how to pronounce it, but I know it's H1GHR Music, something like that. Okay, I'm gonna put it here on the screen. Oh my god, this always happens. I'm gonna put it on the screen. But yeah, I know that he recently signed with Jay Park's global label. And yeah, he came out, he introduced himself, he was talking about how, you know, he was happy about meeting his fans, because he had seen a couple of people in the audience. And yeah, he talked about how next month he'd be going to South Korea and whatnot. So yeah, it was really nice to see, you know, because you could see like his fans were like really close up front. And, you know, they sang along to all his songs. They interacted a lot with him, you know, because he talked a lot between his songs. He talked, you know, with the public, talking about, you know, what the song was about, what his next, you know, moves were going to be, you know, what he has planned for next. And also he would interact with the fans, talking, you know, to the fans, saying thank you for coming. Asking them if they knew the song to sing along and things like that. So yeah, it was really nice to see like the fans really supporting and singing along and being interactive with him. Yeah, it was really nice. And even though his music, like personally, even though his music is a bit, you know, too explicit for me. I wish him the best. You know, his fans, there's a lot of fans there that really like his music, that are very supportive. So yeah, best of luck to, you know, Ted Park and everything over there in South Korea. So yeah, he was the first one. He sang a couple of songs. I think 4 or 5, if I'm not mistaken, around there. So yeah, then after that, the girls came, you know, finally we were able to see G-Idle, and they came in, and I'm telling you, I don't know what happened, but everybody just swarmed, like, towards the stage, as in, like, everybody got really, 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 really close to each other, and then the girls walked in, and everybody's like, "Whoa! And I was like, okay, this is awesome. Like, everybody here is, like, super supportive. You know, they came here for, you know, to support the girls. Obviously, they were fans of Ted Park and, you know, I Love Dance as well. But I was so happy that, you know, the girl group was getting so much, you know, enthusiasm, support, and love. Because, honestly, when it comes to K-pop, the guy groups, the boy groups are the ones who get, you know, the most, how do you say, the most euphoria and enthusiasm and, you know, and support. And it's really nice to see that, you know, that vibe, that whole, just, you know, that atmosphere of love and support and enthusiasm and excitement for a new girl group. They just debuted in May, so it was just really awesome. Everybody's like, oh my God, I know, yes! And so, yeah, they performed 3 songs. The first song was Maze, one of their B-sides from their, you know, what was it, a mini album? I know it's like 6 songs, if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, it's one of their B-side songs. And what else? I was able to take a video of their performance of Maze and then their performance, their La Ta Ta performance. And the first, both performances are already on, you know, here on my YouTube channel. I'm going to leave the card up here, the link up here, so you guys can watch both of them. So, yeah, I had a fan of theirs riding back with me. And I'm telling you, his scream was like, wah! Like, this high-pitched scream. It's like, wow, like, I didn't know people could go so high. So that's why, so when you guys go check out their performances, that's why I put a warning at the beginning of the video, because I had a very enthusiastic fan behind me, and he was just like, wow, I know, yes! And so, yeah, that was for Maze, and it was really awesome, because I liked that song, but I hadn't seen, like, It was awesome to see the choreography along with the song being, you know, interpreted. So yeah, it was just really nice. Everybody was really excited and cheering and singing along. It was nice to hear that people actually knew the song. So yeah, then after that, La Ta Ta came out. After that, they spoke a little bit with the public, you know, they said hi, you know, gave the greetings as a group. And then, you know, say thanks for being here. They really appreciate, you know, us coming out to see them. And also they told us that they would have 2 more songs. One was La Ta Ta. And then the other song, I didn't catch the name of it. But they said something about, I think they choreographed the dance to it themselves, if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, they spoke a little bit with the public. And then they went to La Ta Ta. So yeah, when La Ta Ta came out, forget it. Everybody was screaming, doing the fan chants and everything. And it was awesome. It was just awesome to see them live, because I really liked that song. I like, you know, the whole, how the music video was shot and, you know, their outfits, the whole concept. And I really love, you know, their voices. They have really, their tones of their voices, I just find it like really awesome, really unique. There's one girl, her voice, I think her name is Eunji, if I'm not mistaken, and I really like the tone of her voice. And I really love how, you know, the whole song showcases everybody's singing ability, as well as the rapper's ability as well. So yeah, I just really liked how the lines were distributed. And I don't know, that song is awesome. I like seeing it, you know, being performed live. Everybody was, you know, singing along with the song, and also they knew the fan chants. And yeah, it was just really nice. It was a really awesome performance. And then after that, they performed that other song, which I don't remember the name to it, but the choreography was cool. I really liked the choreography. But then after that, they said goodbye and thank you for being here, and then they were gone. Just like that. And I was like, oh my God, only three songs? I would have liked to, obviously I didn't know, I don't think the event was meant to be like a meet and greet or anything like that. But I would have liked to maybe have heard a little bit more about them, or maybe have a little bit more interaction with them and the fans or something like that. But yeah, it was just really, it was a really short performance. A short section within, you know, the event. But I really enjoyed it. They seemed, you know, really happy to see us, really enthusiastic. They were very responsive, you know, smiling and saying hi to the fans. You know, when they would come up and be closer with the fans and the choreography, you see they give eye contact and whatnot. And yeah, they seemed really happy that, you know, we all had come to support them and whatnot. So yeah, it was nice. It was nice being able to see them perform live. And yeah, that ended around 11, if I'm not mistaken, around 11. And so yeah, they left and I left too because I was tired. I had been many hours standing up and my feet hurt, my feet really hurt. So I was like, it's time to go. I'm just too old for this. So yeah, I got up and went, I walked to 14th Street, got the bus there, and just decided to take the long way home because obviously if I would have gone on the train, I would have gotten there and I would have gone home in 30 minutes. But I wanted to check out, you know, the pictures and the videos that I had taken during the event. So yeah, I just decided to get on the bus and take the long way home. So yeah, that's basically what I did. I checked a couple of pictures. I posted it on my Instagram. Luckily, I was able to get, you know, both the Maze and La Tata performance. And yeah, it was a really nice experience. Overall, it was very unexpected. Like I told you guys, I thought I wasn't going to be able to see them, you know, their flash mob. And I thought, you know, after that, well, if I didn't see the flash mob, then I guess I'm not going to be able to see them, you know, now that they're in New York. And obviously, I wasn't going to be able to see them, you know, at the event on Sunday. So I was like, oh well. But then all of a sudden, it turned out to be, you know, something completely different. I was able to see them on Saturday, thanks to, like, the event they did in the Love Store. Love Store, Love You, something like that. Yeah, I was able to see them there. And then I was able to see them Sunday, you know, perform live. So yeah, it was just really unexpected. And it goes to show you that, you know, just because you're going by yourself to places, you know, doesn't mean you're not going to have fun. And obviously, just because you're going alone by yourself doesn't mean you shouldn't go. I know a lot of people who are like, oh, you know, this person is performing in my city, but I don't want to go alone. That's lame. I don't think I'm going to have fun. From a person who has, you know, for a long time goes alone to events, and, you know, since I got into university, you know, I just learned how to embrace my own presence and doing things by myself. You know, I go out to eat, I go out to restaurants to eat by myself, or, you know, around there, I go out to eat by myself. I go to, you know, to Barnes & Noble, to the library, to the movies by myself. I go to KCON by myself. I go to concerts by myself. Last year I went, you know, to see Taeyeon. And, you know, it's just, if you have the opportunity and if you know, obviously, if it's safe, just go. Just go and, you know, have that experience, you know. It doesn't matter if you go by yourself. It's always, I don't know, my experience, like I said, it's weird. My experience is that I go by myself and I've found people, you know, very nice, very friendly people to talk to, either on the line or, you know, people who are sitting right next to me at the event. So yeah, just go, just, you know, be adventurous. I don't know, just go, you know, have the experience. you don't know, you know, what you're missing out just because you're afraid that it's lame, that you're going by yourself. It's nothing wrong with you going by yourself, with embracing, you know, your own presence in this world. Just go and have fun. I'm telling you, go and have fun, because I had a lot of fun and I went by myself. Don't let that limit you, you know, the new experiences. And then obviously the first time you go by yourself, and then the next time you have a friend with you or something like that. But yeah, it was just really awesome, a really awesome weekend. Very unexpected, but yeah, it was really cool. I hope everything goes well for Idol and their next comeback. They're coming back, you know, this month in August. So yeah, it was just awesome being able to see them perform live. So yeah, that is all for my Idol weekend, my unexpected, adventurous Idol weekend. Thank you so very much for watching part one and part two of, you know, my story time, whatever, story time? Yeah, about, you know, my whole experience last weekend. Thank you so very much for taking the time to watch this video. Comment down below if you were able to, you know, go to the event on Saturday or the event on Sunday. You know, if you were able to go to the store on Saturday. Yeah, just tell me what was your experience, what you liked about, you know, being able to see them perform or being able to see them, you know, in person on Saturday. Who's your favorite member? What's your favorite song of theirs so far? Yeah, or anything you'd like to talk about from, you know, Sunday's performance. Or, yeah, anything you'd like to talk about the girls, leave it, you know, leave your comments down below in the, leave your comments in the comment section below. There you go. So, yeah, thanks so much. Once again, thanks so much for watching. I'll have, hopefully, a new video for you guys in the next couple of days. Like I said, I'm working on my KCON experience. It's going to be a kind of a long video, but it's going to be worth it. I have a lot of pictures and a lot of video footage and a lot of things I like, you know, I like to talk about my own experience going to KCON once again by myself this year. So yeah, thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned to my new videos coming out very soon. And yeah, I'll see you guys hopefully in the next couple of days. Bye.